Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our very first Youth Talk Show. And today's topic is about unleashing our potential with growth mindset, especially for youth and also students. And firstly, I would like to thank for our audiences and also guest speakers who are willing to join us in this very special today, in this very special talk show, And we have two special guest speakers that will share their opinion and also tips on how to to run their business and also to focus on their study. And in this today's talk show will be divided into two parts. First for sharing section, and then the second is for Q&A section. So without any further ado, let's get to our speakers, because I know you all are very excited to listen to our guest speakers today. So I will go to our first speaker, Miss Sinta. She is Miss Sinta. She is the CEO of Wedding Organizer, and now she is in the fourth semester in university. Hello, Miss Sinta. Are you there? We are very pleased to have you here today.
Hello, guys. Good afternoon. Thank you for having me in this talk show. Today we will discuss about
Sinta, good morning, Tati.
Potential with a growth mindset. I'm really happy to join this talk show with you and our audience in Zoom meeting.
Okay, so Miss Sinta, can you share us what is your job desk at work?
Okay, so now I work as wedding organizer, a service that especially help the bride and family to manage party series appropriate concept that has been made before. Now, the proper job of a wedding organizer is to arrange the event, starting marriage agreement, catering, decoration, and until photography. And I think it is a challenging job because I and my team should have a humble personality, quick response, and reliable anytime. Now, after the event finished, the wedding organizer should make sure if the event organized well, and for example, make sure gift from a guest that has already been received in to family from bride. And if you want open wedding organizer service, you should know the detail and the job. And it is important to know.
Thank you, Ms. Sinta, for sharing. That seems that you are, as a student, you also have, you know, the ability to manage your time very well. So can you share us what makes you start doing this job?
Nothing. Nothing, because actually I didn't have a dream job of having a wedding organizer, but my other family has a venue called Juklo. And after the Juklo finished making and Juklo used for worship, after that some people came and say, well, it's a good place for an event and templates, and the hall is used for gymnastics every Sunday morning. And after that, our family decided to make this Juklo into a venue that can be rented for any event. And we serve like decoration, catering, and photography. Now, after pandemic is coming, several months we are closed and we can start again with a protocol team. And we decide to have a double job with a wedding organizer.
I see. It seems that it's actually family properties, and you run this business to, you know, to gain more experience, to gain more, well, yes, that's experience. So can you share with us, how do you overcome the hardships at work while you are also studying?
I have a lot of hardships while working during study. Like, I should manage my time and distinguish where my time to work and to study. And every weekday, I should focus on my study. And on weekend, I should focus on my job. And my way to deal with my hardships while working is I should understand its character of person in my team, so I can work together. Because sometimes, even though we are the same job, and there are a lot of characteristics in every person, besides that, I should have a peace with myself so my job doesn't get messy because of my problem that I face.
Thank you, Miss Hinda. Thank you for sharing that kind of value so we can understand more. And the next question is, what kind of mindset that do you think students nowadays need to know if they want to start their business or if they want to utilize their time?
I think mindset like there is no word to learn new things, even though we may not be young again, but desire for learning will not lose. There is no word too old to start learning something new. So for you all guys that's still young, don't be scared to learn something new that will help you, that will help your self-development for a good career. After that, if you have a failure, please don't feel angry or sad, but we must make it as motivation that will help you close with your success. Also, you must appreciate critique, because critique that will help us to get better.
Thank you, Ms. Hinda, for sharing. And I guess, I think this for sharing section has been done. And we are very, very thankful for Ms. Hinda to share this kind of thought and this kind of values that we can learn from. Thank you, Ms. Hinda. And we will move to our next part, our next section, which is Q&A section. And I guess we already have got a question from Ms. Gabby. Ms. Gabby, are you there? Can you share with us your question?
Okay, I have a question for Ms. Hinda. Can you give us tips for students out there that haven't made the most of their time?
Okay, thank you, Ms. Gabby, for the question. And Ms. Hinda, take your time to answer the question.
Okay, thank you, Gabby, for your question. I'm sure all of you have heard the sentence, time is money, because time runs nonstop, cannot repeat, and cannot be faster. So we as human must use our time as well as possible, and there is no time that throw away, and we can take advantage of time. We can make our time with positive activity, like if you are a student, you can study to achieve your dream, and later we can success because we already take advantage of them as well as possible.
Thank you, Ms. Hinda and Ms. Gabby, for the question. And thank you, Ms. Hinda, for answering the question and give us more knowledge. So I think today's topic about unleashing our potential using growth mindset is already done. And we can wrap up that we have learned a lot from Ms. Hinda that we, for example, like how we implement or how we use the growth mindset to run our business well. We can also focus on our study, for example, like how to overcome our failures, how to manage our time very well, and how to see the chances that we, as a student, we actually have the same capability to run a business. And as what Ms. Hinda has mentioned before about the time is money, that's really a great quote that we can take use or that we can learn from, because as the quotation, it's actually we can see that time is actually really precious. And thank you for everyone here, thank you for the audience and the guest speaker that have been willing to join in our youth talk show today. And I guess this is over, and hope to see you again, everyone, in our next meeting. See you. Thank you.
Thank you, guys. I hope that my experience can benefit for you to start a business while studying. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you, Ms. Hinda.
Thank you.